Well, Maria, good to see you today.
Nice to see you, Dr. Thompson.
And I'm glad you came in today. And I've just gone over your PHQ-9, and it's actually dropping. It's dropped down to 14, which is really good. Mm-hmm. Means that I think this is starting to work.
Yes.
A little bit,
yes,
you think?
Yes.
Okay, good. Well, let's review your homework then. So you have a very, very, very busy activity log here. My, this is the most filled in that I've seen it so far. Yeah. So were you able to do those additional things that we talked about last time that you wrote down that you were going to try to do?
Yes, I did talk to my cousin on the phone.
Okay. All right.
And I
did
do some reading and, of course, watching my favorite TV programs.
Uh-huh. Okay.
But the only thing I didn't do was, let me see, I did get my granddaughter to the park, which she loves.
Good.
Yeah, we both
good.
Love.
Good.
The only thing that was hard for me was on Sunday was to get to church because there was no one to go with. I didn't want to sit there alone.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess after I had those thoughts, I really didn't have a lot of energy to do it. So that's about the only thing I didn't do.
Okay. So that didn't happen this week,
no.
The getting to church. And, you know, last week when you were here, you said that that wasn't too likely, that you were thinking maybe that wasn't going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But you wanted to keep it on the list. So should we keep it on the list for future weeks?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. What would it take to be able to get to church? What would that require so that you were able to do it?
Well, I thought my adult daughter would go with me, but she didn't want to go. She had other things to do. So what I'm trying to get myself is to the point to call maybe the pastor or one of my friends at the church and see if one of them will come pick me up.
Well, that's a good idea. That's a good idea. So what we're talking about here is really called problem solving, okay, where you try to analyze the situation a little more closely, and we try to figure out what's really getting in the way, you know? Mm-hmm. So what's getting in the way seems to be no one to go with, right? Is that right?
That's true.
Okay, no one to go with. And so if you had someone, either your daughter, if that was of interest to her and, you know, fit her schedule, maybe she would go, and that would be nice. Maybe mm-hmm. your granddaughter would go too, and, you know, you'd be a family going.
Mm-hmm.
But if not, then calling the pastor sounds like a really good idea, because I guess they have people in the church that might come and pick you up. And,
yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So do you think that would solve the problem? Then if you had someone to go with, you would actually go?
I think so. I think mm-hmm. that would really encourage me to you know, try and, you know, make it a weekly mm-hmm. activity.
Okay. Okay. All right. Well, I'd recommend then that that's what you do, you know, rather than sort of wait for your daughter to say at the last minute, you know, she can go or she can't go. It might be good during the week to call and try to get it arranged, get it set up for this coming Sunday, and then you can see how it goes, you know, see how it feels being in church.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it used to feel good, so I'm hoping that it's going to feel good to be there mm-hmm. with all my friends.
Me too. Well, what I'd like to work on today is the next phase of this, because I think you're really ready for this now, Maria. So the next phase of it is to help you track more carefully every day of the week the things that you do that are enjoyable. So here we're going to customize your list of pleasant activities, because we've got a few now. We know things that are likely to make you feel good.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll notice that we have going down the side where we can put the list, where we have the blank spaces, and then across the top we have the days. So all that you need to do is put a check mark in the box if that particular thing happened on that day.
Okay.
Does that, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Now, we have two new things on this form. Okay, down here, we ask you for the total number of pleasant things that you did that day. So you just add them up. So it could be 2, 4, 10, you know, whatever it is from this list. And then we ask you for an overall mood score. What, when you look at the whole day, what's your mood overall for the day? How would you characterize your mood for the day?
Okay.
Okay, so that's a little bit different because before we were looking at individual activities, whether or not they made you feel good. Mm-hmm. Now we're looking at, when you look at the whole day, are some days better than others? And then we try to figure out why. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's start by having you record here what pleasant activities you think you're going to want to keep track of. So you want to start to fill it in? I think we can use these, you know, and we can use the ones that you've indicated in previous weeks.
Okay.
So let's see if we could get about 7 or 8 on the list. So that way you leave room in case something new comes up that you want to try.
Yeah.
You could add it. You know, so we want to get to 10, but right now, let's see if we can get 7. So here we have 4, mm-hmm. right? And then from previous weeks, what are some other ones that you could put there that you remember from the previous ones that you filled out?
Well, I have watching TV, my favorite TV
right.
programs.
Okay. Good.
And cooking.
Okay. Yeah, cooking is getting to be enjoyable, mm-hmm. more enjoyable than it was.
Yeah, yeah, my daughter keeps asking me to, Mom, can you make some of that, you know, this dish you used to make? Mm-hmm. She likes the way I make sopa.
Uh-huh.
And mm-hmm. so that was fun to do for the family.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
I want to add baking because I like to bake.
All right.
And I haven't done that in a while either.
Okay.
Baking.
And how about your sister and her visiting and you playing cards together?
Oh, yes, uh-huh.
Should we put that on the list?
Yes, uh-huh. Yeah? So playing cards with my sister.
So you have 8 things.
Yes.
So I think that's enough, you know?
Yeah.
And the goal is every day to try to do at least 4.
4.
Mm-hmm. That's the goal for this coming week. Okay, so you're going to put a check mark
mm-hmm.
when
so this is Monday, Tuesday,
yeah.
Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
So whatever I did on like today is Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
So if I do any of these activities.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can I put on here coming to see you? Because I enjoy these sessions too.
Does that count?
Does that?
Well, it's only once a week, you see. So you'd only have 1 mark.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's a good question, though. Mm-hmm. But we're trying to have things here that you can do frequently during the week, you know, more than once.
Other than coming here. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And then at the end of the day, you're going to get the total, right?
Mm-hmm. And then mm-hmm. my mood score, how mm-hmm. it made me feel.
Mm-hmm. The whole day overall.
Yes.
Okay. All right. And how confident are you that you can do this, Maria?
An 8.
All right. Very good. Okay. Thank you. I'll see you next week then.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson.